Here are some examples of how pollution has changed many species. Number 10. Camouflage change. Tawny owls are some of the most fascinating animals in the world. Their pigmentation has varied throughout time and also dependent on their location. Known as an endemic species of the temperate forests in Europe, these big-eyed birds manage to camouflage themselves with the background as a way to catch their prey and also protect themselves from possible threats. Their natural color spectrum ranges from brown to a lighter shade of brown depending on their location. Some are even white given the presence of snow. As with most areas affected by climate change, certain forests in Europe are now registering warmer weathers, making the pigmentation of tawny owls even darker. Over the past 28 years, a population of the species found in Finland had an increase of darker owls, mainly based on the higher temperatures registered in the Nordic countries' forests. Although a big part of their color change depends on a pigment called pheomelanin, the increasing presence of brown owls has changed the anatomy of an entire species. Number 9. New fish, new trouble. The Madagascar pochard is known as one of the rarest species of diving birds. It commonly inhabits the waters of various lakes on the southern African island of Madagascar. Although its rareness is known within the scientific community, many of the most common threats the species has had to endure are actually because of humans. The area surrounding Lake Alaotra, where the species has been known to live, was used for rice cultivation, which damaged the soil and water reservoirs that these birds use. Added to this, the burning of vegetation and the presence of cattle, animals endangered the area. But the main threat was really the introduction of other species. It's believed that what caused the heavy decline in numbers for this species is the introduction of various fish, which made the population practically disappear between 1940 and the early 1950s. These fish would kill most of the chicks and ruin the pochard's nests, leaving a very endangered adult population. Back in 1960, the last sighting of the animal was registered in Lake Alaotra, and most of the species captured were taken to a zoo in Amsterdam. After that, these birds were believed to be extinct. But in 2006, a few new pochards were seen in the wild at Lake Matsaboremina, renewing hope that one of Madagascar's most popular birds can rebound. Number 8. Late hibernation. For those who don't believe in how hardcore climate change can be on animals, check this out. Even mosquitoes have changed the way they live. The pitcher plant mosquito, an endemic species of the muddy grounds of eastern North America, has made a dramatic change in its behavior in the past few years. It turns out, they're known for hibernating during winter, and essentially, they come back out by the time spring comes. When winter comes, daylight becomes scarce, so they have to hibernate and wait for spring. But now, given how hot temperatures have delayed seasons by a couple of days, their hibernation periods have been pushed later. At first, it was only a thing that mosquitoes from the southern areas would do. Temperatures in the south obviously are higher because of their proximity to the equator. But now, it's become a behavior spread along all the species. The rising temperatures have prompted them to extend the waiting time for their hibernation, changing their behaviors in an unexpected way. Not only this, but now the changes in the temperature have made them go through their process later. They do it for a shorter period. The biggest consequence of altering the breeding season is that it affects all the creatures that rely on these mosquitoes as a source of food. The great tit, that's a bird, by the way, feeds on the mosquito larvae. However, if the mosquitoes have already hatched, the chicks will go hungry, and that means there are more of these mosquitoes around. Hey, at least these guys don't bite humans. Number 7. Higher temps equals more births. With pollution happening almost everywhere on the planet, it's taking a toll on the flora and fauna present in all types of ecosystems. Some examples are more dramatic than others, but that doesn't change the fact that even squirrels are now behaving differently. A clear example is the red squirrel, a common animal of the Yukon area in Canada. The females of the species have recently presented a peculiar trait. They're taking shorter periods of time between being pregnant and giving birth. How is it possible that an entire species is now being born quicker than before? Apparently, the changes in temperature, which means warmer springs and a drier environment, and that has changed the behavior of red squirrels. This was the first time that evidence showed that climate change actually was changing the genetic structure of populations. Whether it's a positive or negative remains to be seen, as only time can tell if an earlier birth benefits red squirrels. Number 6. Coral bleaching. The bottom of the ocean is a fascinating place. Generally, creatures that live at the bottom of the ocean are known for their mysterious ways of living, moving, and mating. But if there is a living being that has created a coping mechanism for humanity's constant devastation of marine ecosystems, it's corals. They have been known for being very sensitive to changes in water temperatures, especially to warmer water. A color-changing mechanism is activated when they've been exposed to warmer water, making their bodies bleach by expelling a colorful algae that lives in them. This algae that lives on coral is extremely important. It provides a number of nutrients corals need for their survival. However, research shows that new species of coral have created a way to adapt to high water temperatures to avoid bleaching. Laboratory tests indicated that corals are coming up with ways of enduring higher temperatures. Over time, certain corals may be able to have a genetic advantage over other corals because of this adaptation. Number 5. Mating ground. Pollution has had terrible effects on all ecosystems on a global scale. The most common form that has prompted some of the strangest behaviors in animals is chemical pollution. Most pollution are known endocrine disruptors, chemicals that enable changes in the production of hormones, causing birth defects, and even cancer. For animals and wildlife, this has been particularly true, especially for their sexual organs. Numerous investigations performed on a range of animals, such as gulls, rats, and frogs, have found pollution has influenced behavioral changes when it comes to nesting, parenting, and more importantly, mating. The application of insecticides and other chemical compounds on animals' habitats has been reported as the main cause for their physiological changes. A study found that starlings, a bird species that uses flaunting and displaying as a mating tactic, who were exposed to a certain insecticide, decreased their mating activities by almost 50%. Other studies have shown how the exposure of lead within gulls affects their body's balance. A number of other strange biological effects, such as goldfish becoming hyperactive because of the presence of atrazine, have also been reported. Number 4. Brink of extinction. Unfortunately, nowadays, it's very common to hear about how a new species is now considered to be endangered. This is a very real case. The Red River turtle, known as the largest freshwater turtle in the world, is on the brink of extinction. To this day, only 3 species are left in the entire world. 2 in the Suzhou Zoo in China, and another one in the waters of the Dong Mo River in Vietnam. A 4th turtle had been living in captivity until it died back during February 2016. Now, scientists are hoping to slowly repopulate the area with the one male specimen they have. But how exactly did these turtles become endangered? Urban development along the banks of the Red River in China became a serious threat to the species, destroying most of its natural habitat since the late 1950s. As China is searching for renewable sources of energy, more dams are being built along the natural water reservations that were home to numerous animals, including the Red River turtle. A considerable danger to an already endangered animal. Climate change isn't helping either, as higher temperatures makes an unstable home for the Red River turtle. Number 3. Greater bamboo lemur's habitat is disappearing. Known as the biggest species of lemurs currently living in the world, the greater bamboo lemur stands as the world's most endangered primate. Their natural habitat is southern Madagascar, although there are fossils that indicate that they were once widespread throughout the whole island. Great bamboo lemurs are extremely social. They live in groups that number in at least the 20s. Although they were believed to be extinct, a new group of lemurs was found back in 1986. One of the main reasons they've become an endangered species is habitat degradation. Slash and burn agriculture, bamboo cutting, and mining have massively reduced the size of their territories, making them now occupy only 4% of their original habitat. Over the past 30 years, their population has been reduced by 80%. Not only that, the life expectancy of a typical generation of greater bamboo lemur has also been reduced. As their habitat has been mostly degraded, and without any laws regarding official protection, the situation hasn't been looking good. This is the main reason these guys are constantly featured as an endangered species every year. Number 2. Almost gone and back again. A common inhabitant of the European forests, sparrowhawks have struggled for decades to remain alive. It's no secret that human behavior has been its biggest enemy, with accounts of English hunters stating how disruptive these birds were for their hunting efforts. One journal even said that whenever any of these birds were found, their nests should be destroyed. Although people should start with the parent birds first. As it turns out, it was another man-made effort that managed to almost completely get rid of these birds. Chemical pollution. During the latter half of the 20th century, sparrowhawk populations started to decrease to the point where they were almost gone. The introduction of numerous insecticides changed these birds in many ways. Their eggs started having much thinner shells, leading to their chicks to die soon after birth. Oh yeah, just the presence of these chemicals would poison the birds as well. Regions that made use of certain insecticides showed a significant decrease in sparrowhawk population, and other regions that didn't use the same insecticides did not. However, the populations recovered after the chemicals were banned, and the Eurasian sparrowhawk is now relatively common. To this day, they remain the bird species that's gone through the largest amount of chemical pollution. Number 1. Mumbai Blue. Blue is a great color, but not when it comes to a chemical reaction that turns animals' skin this color. Industrial waste has long been a source of stress for many developing countries who still haven't found an efficient way of dealing with it. And in this case, India became alarmed with the number of stray dogs that turned blue. The situation believed to be caused by a factory that was known for dumping their waste in a nearby river in Mumbai. A total of 11 dogs were seen around the streets of Mumbai sporting their alien-like blue fur, caused by the exposure to air and water pollutants. A number of complaints were received in the local environmental office of Mumbai, prompting authorities to do a full-scale investigation into the problem. Although the animals seemed to be unharmed by the blue dye, as a group of people managed to wash the blue dye off of one of the dogs, the company responsible was shut down. The Taloja industrial area has long been a zone of concern for environmental activists, mainly because of its proximity to the Cassidy River and the amount of chemicals that are dumped in it. How about no more blue dogs? Here's what's next.
Wouldn't typically pose any sort of real danger, but for those animals much lower on the food chain, a centipede is not to be messed with, especially a giant centipede. With a specialized pair of venomous appendages, these foot-long arthropods crawl around South America and the Caribbean, looking for insects and small mammals.